Greetings, fellow Sparkies, and welcome to the Resistance. I'm Regan, and yes, that's Regan with a rolling R, and yes, I do have a foreign accent, because I'm actually one of those pesky alien electricians undertaking the maintenance of this fine empire one socket at a time, so you don't have to. But let's leave that for later, and today let's talk about new toys. In November of 22, at the annual Elex show in Surrey, I met with Megger's own Peter Wade to discuss the all-new multifunction tester MFT-X1. And the following is my report. Hi Peter, could you tell us about the new multifunction tester? What's new, and is it going to be another game changer for Megger?
It is a game changer when it comes to the battery technology. Similar to your drills where you have battery packs. And obviously, if you run out of them, obviously you have the adapter where you can use rechargeable batteries or you can use alkaline batteries, okay, in the adapter, because the adapter actually comes with its own case, so you could have a number of them hanging around and just put it in there and just put it back in the unit. Okay, this charge up separately, so we've got a charger there. So that takes about 15 minutes, gives you enough power to finish the day sort of thing. Recharge an hour to a couple of hours and you have a full battery pack. But the idea is you have a couple of these standing around, put straight in, ready to go. So that's one game changer in it. Second game changer is in the base there. If I take that out again, there's two clips, you just pull them apart. Okay. Underneath where the fuse goes, there's an SD card. Okay. And the SD card can be used for updating the firmware, updating elements to the testing. So things like, I'll say power quality, okay. We might be able to put online the software patch for power quality as a firmware upgrade. You download that onto your card, put your card in the unit, and then it becomes a power quality index. But if there's any changes to the regulations or any changes to testing, like for argument's sake, say in 3 or 4 years' time, they say, right, we're not testing at 250 or 500 anymore, we're doing 300 and 600. We would upload that to the internet, onto our website. You would go on, download that onto the card, put it into your meter, and then to 250 to 500 would change to 300 and 600. Right? Using the screen, if we go straight through to the installation test, we've got the same settings on the dial as we see on the screen. It's red because it's always red for us, installation test. You have a button at the top to select the voltage. We also have a variable setting on there, so you can change that to suit your own testing. So you might have something like that 750 volts, where 500 is not enough and 1,000 is too much. So you can change that and put your own variable setting in there. Okay. We've also got actual voltage used, where the regs call for plus 25%, minus nothing, or zero. This is plus 2%. So we're only going to put into a 500 volt circuit, we're going to put in 5 volts or something. So we do the test as normal, press and hold down, wait till you get the needle to go across and get a value, take your finger off the button, discharges 505 volts there. You've also got the leakage current that used in that test, so you can see. We have now then a button at the top here for transferring the data directly into our search suite software package. Okay, so press the button there and we'll take you in. It's a Bluetooth connection, you see it flashing at the bottom there. That means it's not paired, and you don't pair this with the software. The software will automatically pick that up and pair directly via the software. Okay, so when that goes solid, you've got the connection. So that's installation testing. You've also, on this dial, got the ability to change the values if you don't want to use the buttons at the top. But when you change that, it changes it at the top there. And now we have a nice, clear, full-colour display on where you connect in, and that's on every test. Continuity. What we do with continuity, we have a screen, it's an auto start circuit. So as soon as it starts to measure a circuit, it gives you a resistance. For continental, we've got the ability to do it alternatively, where in the UK it's just one way, so that's set at one way. We've already nulled the leads, so we know it's nulled out and there's the resistance of the thing. So if the leads go in, I can do my test and not worry about any value. You also got the ability to look at the previous result. So if you're doing a lot of testing, you can see what the last result was. There's a reminder. Okay. We have the ability to add a clamp in our MMC-1010, which goes from 1 milliamp up to 300 amps. We also have the ability to put a third party clamp in there, as long as it's 1 millivolt to 10 millivolts. If we then go, you can the voltage. Again, you've got the dial coming up there. So at the moment we're on DC, up to 1,000 volts, three phase, single phase, volts, millivolts on there. Again, you've got the ability to put that into the test receipt as well, your frequency. If you do phase rotation or phase sequencing, it automatically comes up on this side, tells you what it is, 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 2, 1, whatever it is, comes up. Loop test is a big change for us. On our 1741 and 1741 Plus, we have the confidence meter, which enables you to do less testing because the AI chip in there, the way it does the analysation of the circuit, it gives you more repeatable results, okay? So what we've now got, we've got that on the two-wire test that we have, and we also have a two-wire high-resolution test, 0001 ohm. So we can go up to 50 kA on the fault current on this now, and you can put this close to source. So you can sit this on the transformer and it would do a test on the transformer, whereas the previous 1700s wouldn't do it. Okay? And it's easy to select. You've got Z at the top there, Z max, Z reference, R1 and R2. We can also do volt drop on the circuit from across the circuit and the whole circuit now. Okay, back to Z. No RCD gives you your two-wire high resolution or a two-wire normal test or a three-wire test. And then we can do RCD. We have a setting for EV, which means a lot of testers will do a loop test on these and trip it out. But because we've got this EV setting on here, it won't trip it out when you do a loop test through it. It goes straight through the device and enables you to do it. Okay, and we've also got the no RCD tip. But we've got the confidence meter at the top, that will collapse on a noisy circuit, a clean circuit. Noisy circuit, it might take a bit longer, but it will give you a result. But if you can notice there, we've got the lead null from our continuity. It's already been applied into this circuit. So we're using the same lead value here. So that means if you're using a wander lead to do a loop test, you would null that in the continuity circuit. It automatically appears here, so you haven't got to worry about taking out another half an ohm value of your reading. You've also got a widget at the bottom here, which is always give you a constant live voltage when you're on a live circuit. Okay. The RDC comes with this configurator box. And for Europe, we've also got the ability to do a 2x test in there. Okay, but we've set it up for UK, but you can put it in if you want. If we go to the settings, I'll show you. We've got this configurator. If I go into there, I can now select two, and it's enable. Okay, I'll disable that, but I'll also disable the five. Okay, there we go. I'll save that, come back to my RCD. Thank you. And now you can see I've taken them both out. So that is my test sequence. That's all I'm going to be doing. So this is your EV with an A or a B breaker. AC circuit, AC breaker, I do apologize. A, B's not on there at the moment, but when it comes out, it will have. And we also have the RCD. But if I take it off the auto, I can do a half, one, five individually. We've got earth electro testing on here. So at the moment it's just two pole. So I look at that, it's just a two pole test. When it comes out, it will have three pole on it. And then in about 6 months time, I think after the release, if it's not on the release, we're not sure it's still coming out on the release. It'll be an update. This has no data storage, but we can transfer the data directly by Bluetooth, but it will have coming soon. Again, that might be an update that comes out later. Or it might be with the release of the model. Still not sure yet. Okay. But this dial carries on, doesn't stop there. Okay, so we know when we look at this dial, we've got the features on there. So we go back to where I was talking about power quality update as a purchase. Okay, you would load it in. Okay, and when you get to this point and go the next step, that would go up and you would have power quality. And you, all you need then is the lamp. So you can apply that to other things like specific EV, anything really, what we think needs or what changes come or what the market dictates and requires. So this unit, though you're buying it now, is a unit, well, we look at it as renewable, you know, you're not wasting it, you're not chucking it away. With the older stuff, you get to a point, if you need to put more information into it or features, you've got to make another unit. With this one, you just got to upgrade the firmware.
How will we access those updates and new features? Is it going to be some sort of subscription or...?
No, the subscription base is purely for the software. This update is going to be free charge for the software. Some may be chargeable, but most of them will be free. But it keeps, if the regulations change, you can keep your meter up to date with the regulations.
Well, in addition to your famous two-wire loop test, Megger is also known for the quickest RCD test on the market. Will the X1 follow the tradition and be just as quick as the previous model?
Yeah, I'm nodding. You can't see it on camera, but I'm nodding, yeah.
How much does it cost compared to the previous model it is set to replace?
Well, this isn't actually placing that. Okay, it's an addition to. Now, what happens in 3 or 4 years' time, no one knows. But at the moment, this is a new technology, new platform. It's got the new TrueLoop confidence meter, so it's a completely different way of doing testing. Price-wise, hasn't been agreed yet.
Okay.
Would it be? But obviously, it'll be a little bit more expensive than the current one. But how much by? I'm not sure at the moment.
And when can we expect it on the market and how soon will we know the price?
Mid-January to mid-February. That's when that should be available. You'll see a lot more advertising now that we've given a bit of a launch here. You'll see more advertising coming through about features and bits and pieces. But it's not available until mid-January, February. Okay. So hopefully we'll know the price perhaps in December. If not, we should know the price by January.
Thank you. Since my interview with Peter, at least one supplier is already taking pre-orders for the FMT-X1, and to be honest, the price doesn't look bad at all. Coming in at about £1,350 plus VAT, the X1 slots just above Qtex KT66 and a tad below Metrel's Eurotester. But is it too much, too little? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. And that's all the current affairs I have for you at the moment, brave Sparkies. If you feel like it, do join the resistance, return for our next covert meeting. And now please calmly follow the exit signs while pressing all the appropriate buttons on your way out. I'm Regan of the Resistance, over and out.